Now look at part three. For each question, write the correct answer in the gap. Write one or two words, or a number, or a date, or a time. Look at questions 14 to 19 now. You have 20 seconds. You will hear a radio presenter called William talking about a photography course he did.
I had a great time away on holiday, and one of the things I did was go on a two-day photography course about taking photos of people. It was for beginners, and I was given quite a few tips, some of which I think are really useful. For example, getting your position correct is really important. They said a common mistake is to stand too far away from the person. You get a much better result if you get close to them, as they take up more of the photo. It's also important to make sure the camera is at the same height as the person, especially if you're taking one of a child. A really useful tip was to pay attention to the background. The person will stand out much more if the background is as plain as possible. This will help you to focus on the subject of your photo. Although most smartphones come with a flash to provide extra light, they suggested we try to make as much use as possible of daylight. Doing this will make the colours more accurate and the photo will appear more natural. We're all used to asking someone to say cheese when we're about to take their photo. To get a more interesting picture, they recommended taking a photo of the person when they don't know you're about to do it. Perhaps they're reading or looking out of the window. Finally, they told us to take plenty of photos so we can practice our skills. They said we should aim to take at least 3 photos of people every day. These can be of friends and family or even strangers if you ask their permission.
Now listen again.
I had a great time away on holiday, and one of the things I did was go on a two-day photography course about taking photos of people. It was for beginners, and I was given quite a few tips, some of which I think are really useful. For example, getting your position correct is really important. They said a common mistake is to stand too far away from the person. You get a much better result if you get close to them, as they take up more of the photo. It's also important to make sure the camera is at the same height as the person, especially if you're taking one of a child. A really useful tip was to pay attention to the background. The person will stand out much more if the background is as plain as possible. This will help you to focus on the subject of your photo. Although most smartphones come with a flash to provide extra light, they suggested we try to make as much use as possible of daylight. Doing this will make the colours more accurate and the photo will appear more natural. We're all used to asking someone to say cheese when we're about to take their photo. To get a more interesting picture, they recommended taking a photo of the person when they don't know you're about to do it. Perhaps they're reading or looking out of the window. Finally, they told us to take plenty of photos so we can practice our skills. They said we should aim to take at least 3 photos of people every day. These can be of friends and family or even strangers if you ask their permission.
That is the end of part 3.